Good morning. Always a good morning when God allows you to arrive this morning. It's always a good morning. I greet all men and women all the time with good morning. It's always a good morning when you allow to arrive this morning. Corinthians chapter 3, I like to read right now from the very beginning before we go into any further conversation. Verse 16. Know ye that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you. Know ye that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you. So many of us forget that we are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells within us. For God is a spirit, and we are spirit. And because we are spirit, and we walk in spirit and in truth, then we should always be happy, and we should always have positive formation to introduce into the atmosphere to our brothers and our sisters, because there is too much darkness in the world. Verse 17, if any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy, for the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. God saying that ye are the temple, meaning we are the temple. And if any man defile the temple of God, God will destroy him. Verse 18, let no man deceive himself. If any man amongst you seem to be wise in this world, let him become a fool. Let he may be wise, that he may be wise. Let him become a fool, that he may be wise. Many of us think ourselves to be wise, and if we think ourselves to be wise, then we are only foolish. So it is better to become a fool that we may be able to become wise, because God is wise. And to think ourselves to be wise, meaning that we're putting ourselves in a position as if we have wisdom and that we do not get the wisdom from God, for we ourselves think that we are wise. Not that God is wise, but we think ourselves to be wise as if we have wisdom. Wisdom comes from God. So become a fool that you may get wisdom. For if you think that you are wise, then you are a fool. I hear people talking about they're an atheist or an agnostic, and I say to myself, they must be sad. I ask the person, if I ask them if you believe in God, and one says no. I ask them if you believe in the devil, and one says yes. Well, how can you believe in the devil and not believe in God? Well, they only say that they believe in the devil because they need someone to fight. So God is their opposition. As long as they have an opponent, they can be in the arena. So they will step up to you and tell you how they believe in the devil, but they don't believe in God. Because they want to be in the arena, and you're their opposition. Because they can oppose you, and that gives them strength in their character. But I tell you to ignore the devil. Do not give opposition to the devil. You need not explain yourself to someone who says They believe in the devil, but they don't believe in God. Then you have others that say they don't believe in God nor the devil, that everything just is. Well, imagine back in the days when America was first founded. I'm just saying America, for instance. And these were the days of the Wild Wild West, you know, where it was Murphy's Law. Everybody knows what Murphy's Law means. It was Murphy's Law. And the only rulers was Smith and Wesson. Smith and Wesson. You know them rifles. Smith and Wesson was the rulers. Imagine there to where everybody made their own laws because everybody was outlaws. How would you like it if you could not call the police when someone broke in your house or someone done something to you because there was no one caught to call because there were no laws? So when you say that you don't believe in nothing, but you want justice when your hand calls for justice because you feel as if somebody treated you unjust, so you believe in something. You do believe in something. We all believe in something. But I can imagine if the world was ruled by people that said they don't believe in the devil or they don't believe in God or the devil, we would have a very terrible world. It would be very dark. And people of those forms of character makeup that continuously introduce those dark clouds into the atmosphere of our society are making it worse for the believers in one sense, but not worse for the believers in another sense, because light always shines through darkness. And not only that, there are more disbelievers in God than there are believers in God. But God always seems to make an equalizer, because God is God. And because God is God, no one's going to overrule the righteous. You will not overrule the righteous of God. God is God, God was God, God is God, and God will always be God. So I don't care how much you talk about you don't believe in God. I don't care about how much you talk about you believe in the devil. You know, your words are out there in the atmosphere, and it is terrible because you introduce darkness into the light of minds of young ones as well as old ones, because that is because you have no hope. And it is very sad, and I really feel for you, because I cannot imagine having no color to where you are always colorblind. I cannot imagine having no color to where you are always colorblind. I cannot imagine to where it doesn't matter because you see everything in black and white and there's no living color. This is very sad, my brothers and my sisters, when you get up and you have nothing to live for. When all you go for the work is just for the objects of the world, to get new houses, new cars, more money. And your kids go around not worshiping God, not praying over their food, and living and dying in vain. And it is sad that it is that way, but everyone is not the children of God. And it is very sad that it is that way. But as the stop sign is on the corner, it's only there for me to recognize that I need to stop. And when I see the things that you do, I don't want to do them. And I wish people look at you so they know that they need to stop.